problem. If NSE will not allow, when you put it request to NSE people, okay, sir, I have an exam 5 where I have to do lot of calculation. So either you give me your 20 pages or allow me my 20 pages. Okay, so in that condition, all participants have allowed to carry your 20 pages with them. Second, you have to attend exam like a offline exam. Offline exam means ke when we attend our graduation or post-graduation exam, which is we have to submit the paper. And when we have to submit the paper, we make sure that ke we write it into very systematic way, into proper, you can say, neat and clean way. So what happened that ke examiner sometime may give a mark for the your good handwriting or neat and cleanliness. Why I am saying ke there is a people don't understand the limitation of MCQ, because when we see there is a MCQ, these four options are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you have to take the one. What is the limitation is that I have asked one 5-mark question, and 5-mark question has a 10 variable. You beautifully handle 9 variable, but one variable you missed out. Okay, even I sit in exam, I may also missed out. Okay, so I missed out one variable, and based on one variable, my answer is not matching. Example, out of 4, then I guess one nearest answer, example 3. But unfortunately, it was not right answer, instead of 4 was right answer. So now what happened that examination doesn't get any idea, na? If you have submitted offline paper, you put it a 2-page description, how you have solved the paper, you submitted to the examiner come to know, you beautifully solved the all steps, perfect way, and last step there is a one minor mistake. Example, if I say in simplicity, like say you have to calculate the tax liability. Okay, you have calculated taxable tax liability, then salary tax liability for the taxable income, then the income from capital gain, income from house property, everything. Last, you forgot to add sesh, and your exam answer is not matching because you forgot unknowingly. एक छोटी चीज भी आप क्या कर गए? You missed out to add the final sesh value into answer, and your answer is not matching, and you take the nearest one. So what happened that you lose all 4 mark or 5 mark. So there is a biggest disadvantage of MCQ exam. They don't know, examiner doesn't come to know about the process how you are solving. They are only have a idea with your answer. So even someone has spent single second to tick the answer, and that answer is that person may get the 4 or 4 mark or 5 out of 5 mark. Okay, and you have spent 20 minutes time, but answer is not matched. Sometimes they scientifically design the answer. So like say out of 10 variable, if you miss the one variable, there is an answer. If you miss 2 variable, there is an answer. If you miss the 3 variable, there is an answer. So out of 10 variable, you unknowingly miss the one variable. Instead of begin, you answer with the end. Type 1, you insert type 2, type 0, there is answer. You forgot to add existing value. Question was asked that calculate the SIP value into existing equity fund. But somehow that existing equity fund value you forgot. So your answer is matching with the solution, 4 option, but that is a incorrect answer. So when you move out of paper and you realize that most of the answer were matched with the, was right, but why I failed? So what is I explain here in online examination, and in MCQ examination, you require 100% perfection, or you can say you have to desire for 100% perfection. Because if you be a 1% imperfection, and 1% imperfection may lead to a wrong answer, and you may lose a 5 mark. Okay, so I'll share how you will attend the offline exam. Third is, don't see your answer. यानी कि चार ऑप्शंस है वो देखने की जरूरत नहीं. मैंने काफी लोग देखे कि they look the 4 option first and then they decide and they go it into reverse the direction and they try to solve the example. So it is not right way. Don't see answer. You have to match the, you have to solve the sum and then you have to see whether answer is there or not. Fourth is important. You have to learn and master time tested 5-step process. So right now I'll introduce 5-step process, which is a secret of success of our participant, and it would be for you also when you will attend the exam 5 in April or May. So first steps in time tested 5-step process is read question twice, because until you don't read twice the question, it is applicable for 2 mark and 3 mark also. It is not necessary only we are talking about 4 and 5 mark, we are talking about each and every question. So until you don't read the question twice, you may not able to understand what is asked. I will just show you one question. So this is one module question. It is not a module question, is a 2 mark question. I am talking about 2 mark question. There is a one question I highlighted here. Yes, repeat please. Read question 1.
A mutual fund holds a 91 day treasury bill issued at 98.25, redeeming at 100. If there are 34 days to maturity, what is the value of the instruments on its books?
So now tell me what you have to do in this example. Yeah,
please. 98.25 is the value. Value is 98.25.
Okay, it is PV.
Okay.
Yeah. And FV is 100 rupees. What you have to do?
Yield, you have to calculate the yield. You are not to calculate only the value of the instrument. The value is 98.25.
So even as this simple example you are not getting, but when I demonstrate you will simply get it the question. So that's the reason I this
one minus 34. The number of days we need to calculate.
Yeah, that is first thought should come in my mind. Okay, what instrument says okay, mutual fund was issued, this treasury bill was bought by mutual fund company, okay, at 98.25 and is going to redeem after 91 days at 100 rupees, and today you are 34 days away from the maturity. So what is the time spent, how many number of days you hold instrument? 57 days. Okay, that is one good thing. Okay, I'll just share. So first read the question twice. I'll explain first. Second would be draw a right timeline. Third is not important information. Fourth step is list down steps is basically how you solve the sum, and fifth is your calculation. So what I try to explain to my participant, when you approach any financial planning calculation, out of 10 minutes you have, example if it is an advanced calculation, approximately 70% time you would be doing a planning, and only 30% maximum, this is the minimum I am saying, and this is I am saying maximum, 30% you would be doing a execution. But what I have observed, people are doing exactly opposite. They are just reading the example and starting their Excel or starting their calculator. So Excel or calculator is a tool. It is not a solution, it is not an answer that will give. Your brain will produce the answer. Okay? So that's the reason to break the process. To we want to eat the elephant, but we couldn't eat the elephant as a whole. So we are dividing into pieces. So we can eat the elephant. So what first step is read the question twice. So it will come to know what exactly asked. Where Sushil ji has identified that already 57 days is completed, so we have to find the value as on 57 day of the issuance. Second is draw right timeline. Third is important information. So any step will not miss out, because if we miss out one particular information, then chances that we may end with the wrong answer. Then list down steps. So how you solve the example, so you know from beginning okay, what is my way. You are creating a roadmap for your journey. Suppose if I want to go from Mumbai to, example, which is unknown place, example, let's say Goa by road, I don't have idea. But if I am having a roadmap and I just understand roadmap in detail, and if I have query, I ask to one person who has already gone visited, so what happened then, ki my journey would be smooth. So that's how we are creating our journey smooth, by using the creating a roadmap. So here, what was the question? Question was, a mutual fund holds a 91 day treasury bill. So it was issued, example, on a 1st January. I am just putting one date, okay, and it will mature after how many days? 91 days. Okay, so what would be the day? Maybe 1st April or 2nd April, 1st April already, because January 31, then 28 plus March is 31, so 60 plus 62 plus 20, 90. So example, 2nd April 2012. Okay, so this is the timeline we come to know. Okay, we have visualized, as you know that okay, visual would be even more powerful. You can say one picture tells you 1000 words. If you want to talk about, if you want to tell story to someone by with help of words, people may not understand, but if it is supported by the picture, people will understand. So on a 1st January 2013, the instrument is issued at which rate? 98.25 is going to redeem at 100 rupees. Why I have mentioned minus?
Investment.
So I'll, during the day, we'll also learn the principles. The first principle I am teaching you in well advance, okay, whatever goes out of pocket, it is known as a minus, and whatever comes in pocket, it is known as a plus. So minus 98.25 means investment, you are getting a maturity of 100 rupees. Now what it says, okay, today you have completed how many days? 57 days. So you can say 30 January plus you can say practically today is 18th 2013, okay, so you completed approximately 31 plus 17, you are on a 17th of February. So here what would be the value in my book? What is the value in my book on a 57th day? Okay, so now tell me Priyesh, okay, what would be the, you draw right timeline, so you come to know about the picture, what do? You note down the important information. So kai baar log galti kya karte hai, 34 days lete hai instead of 57 day, because you are 34 days away. So I just say 34 days ka to wrong calculation ho jata hai. So there is the answer. Now what I would do, what steps I'll write? This is a very basic PMT calculation. So my next step kya aayega, pehla step kya aayega when I go here, first step.
No,
but main kya karunga abhi, mujhe ye timeline pata hai how to solve. So mere steps kya rahenge?
So
you come to know I. Now what you will do in a first step, what you find? I. second step, what you will do, you have an eye.